Hey, welcome guys. In this video I'm going to discuss about sharpless epoxidation method. Okay, so let's say you have an allylic alcohol, and if you epoxidize it with say metachlorobenzoic acid MCPBA, which I discussed as the epoxidizing agent, the Prelipschitz reaction, you will be getting both products, both enantiomers. One, the attack will attack from top phase and from the bottom phase. You cannot control the stereoselectivity, right? These both will form 50-50 because the two phases of this alkene is enantiotropic, and the probability of attack from either phase is equal. Now if you want to get one particular product, either this or this, then you have to use the sharpless epoxidation method. Okay, so what are the reagents used in sharpless epoxidation method? So in this epoxidation method, you have to use this reagent, tart butyl hydroperoxide, right? Tart butyl hydroperoxide, then titanium isopropoxide, and plus date or minus date. So what is date? Date is diethyl tartarate, right? So this is your diethyl tartarate, OH CO2 it is. This is plus date, right? So this is nothing but the ester of the ethyl ester of the tartaric acid. So this is plus. If you make this bond, this then it will be minus, right? So what you are using, plus or minus, according to that you will be getting your epoxide. And in this case tart butyl hydroperoxide, this oxygen is actually the oxygen that will be donated in forming the epoxide. And this titanium isopropoxide is working here as a framework, and this plus date or minus date is chiral auxiliary. So this will induce the chiral environment by which you will get your selective product. Now the mechanism of this reaction, how you get the stereoselectivity, that is very complicated thing, and you don't have to bother about that for your competitive exam, right? You just have to know the outcome, and that outcome is very simple, and I will be explaining the mnemonic of how to predict which product you will get, right? So for that you have to draw your alkene in a special way. So let's say this is your alkene, this is your allylic alcohol, and you have to draw it like this. So the rule is if you have this alkene in the plate perpendicular to this board, so this is perpendicular to the plane of the board, so this is your alkene like this, okay, and then your CH2OH group is coming from the board towards you, right? So your CH2OH group will be like this. Like this. So this is your OH, and this alkene is in the plane. Now when you are watching this alkene like this, and if you add minus date, that is minus diethyl tartarate, you will be getting a epoxide above, right? And in the same configuration, you can say if you add plus date, you will be getting epoxide below. Right. So this position is fixed. You have to watch it like this. The alkene is in the plane of the board, and your CH2OH is coming towards you like this. And then the minus date will epoxidize on the top phase, and plus date will epoxidize on the bottom phase. So if you remember this thing, how you have to draw and what you will get the outcome, then you can solve any problem. And one further point I have to mention is that you have, let's say you have a case where you have two alkenes and your situation is like this. This is your substrate and you are given say minus date. So what will be your product? Now there are two alkenes, but the alkene which is adjacent to this hydroxyl group, that will be epoxidized. And in this case, again, you have to draw it like this. So you have to just rotate it. You can rotate it to draw like this. And then minus date is given. So this is the same configuration as I have written here. And you can apply the mnemonic. So minus will epoxidize from the top face. So you will be getting this, which, okay, this. So this is stereoselective epoxidation, and the all any example they have given, the same concept is there. You have to draw it in a perfect way, and then you can say either it can attack from the top face or from the down face. So that's all. You can practice problems from Csir-Net. There is nothing complicated in the problem. You have to just remember the mnemonic. And I think this video will be helpful for you. Thank you for watching.